Wow. Have a seat. Love your shoes.
I love my shoes. They're amazing. They look like this. Check out my shoes. I love my shoes.
Sorry. But my shoes are great. I like my kids more than my shoes. But it's close. It's close. These are pretty great shoes.
We can do this interview like musical style. I ask a question, you sing it.
So you have to ask the question singing as well. Then.
No, I can't sing.
But you know about style. Because
why?
You were the most stylish man in Holland in 1852.
That was a really long time ago.
Yeah, they loved your clogs, man.
They loved your clogs. And they still do. And they love your music. They've been loving it for quite a long time now.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you. And what do you do?
I write about death.
And what is it about death that makes you want to write about it?
No, actually, I'm an actress and I make television programs, but I'm also intrigued about death and I don't want to die.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Because I love my life.
Yes, please. Me too. Well, but science is really working out things.
Ask him the question about angels.
Oh, ask me the question about angels.
No. I have a more important question.
Yeah, okay.
If it's possible, would you want to live forever? If the people around you would also live and you would be still healthy the whole time?
Yeah, I love my life about the song. Yeah, yeah. But also, if you don't mind me asking, how old are you?
41.
Okay, 41. So when did the thing about death come? Was it like at 40?
When I was 10 years old.
Oh, so this has been a lifelong thing?
Yeah.
Because up until I was 30, I thought I was immortal.
Yeah, and, me too.
And then when I got to 30, I was like, this stuff can break and I can die. Yeah. And that was a shock. And then when I got to 40, I was like, oh, I can see death from here. And it's weird, right?
Yeah.
It's weird. Is it something, because you've written about, sorry about this.
That's not just it. I understand, I don't have rests.
So because you've written about it, does it consume your thoughts more because you've written about it and you have to think about it?
Well, I was able for this magazine to also interview a lot of scientists that are really working on this. And they have, like, there is a vision of maybe really being immortal in the future. But I think maybe not in this lifetime, so we have to... How do you say that? Freeze?
Come back. We have to come back.
No, freeze. Then, so don't...
Yeah,
don't
cryogenics. Cryogenics. Yes,
put yourself in the freezer.
You also...
They're going to freeze my head.
No, I find that... I want the whole thing.
No, just my head.
Just a head. On his body.
Yeah. And your voice, though.
Well, listen.
You said, I don't want to die, but I ain't keen on living either. That has changed, obviously.
Yeah, that has changed. I now have a wonderful wife that's made me see sense, that's forced me to see sense. But my life is a lot better than it was when I wrote that song.
Was that in a dark period?
Yeah. We have our dark periods, and, you know, I've been through the depression and stuff. I'm sure, sure you have. Just because I guess that's what you've had because of the death thing. But, yeah, that was then, and that was my 20s. And it was, you know, it was great times outside, successfully I was doing amazing, but inwardly it was like sort of brutal and dark, but I made a good song out of it.